Hello my friends, Rune here again. I bought this thing, T4E TR50 extender BLK. Looks like this. Barrel is steel, but the inside diameter is 15 millimeter, not 12.7. So I took a PVC pipe. It is 13 millimeter inside. So I thought, let's see how that goes, if it works. The thing I'm worried about is that since the barrel from the HDR50 is not going all the way out, there will be a gap. And when I have the, of course, this way in, the PVC pipe in here, the escaping CO2 gas might blow the plastic part apart. I don't know. The most ideal setup would be that it would have a continuing barrel all the way. The steel barrel can be removed. Just remove this screw and this screw, and then the inner plastic part here will fall out, and then you can unscrew this barrel nut and push the whole barrel out the end, rear end. So it's a bit dusty now because I have been filing and grinding with the PVC pipe. But it sits like so. It is meant, as I understand it, that this will not increase velocity. It is just there to look cool from the factory. So when you are shooting, part of the CO2 gas will vent upwards, some of them out here, some of the gas out the hole in the rear there, and also through a hole in the bottom. I'm not sure if it is visible there. Yeah, maybe. There. Through the bottom part and out there. So, yeah, you can also put on rails on the side of the let's see, it's meant to sit something like this. It has this piece here that goes into the corresponding hole there, and you attach it with two screws there. Same on the other side, and comes with an Allen key and screw, and it also comes with this nasty looking muscle brake, whatever you want to call it. This one is also steel, very heavy and pointy. I think it's the same thing that sits on the HDX. Looks like so, but this will make it extremely front heavy, and yeah, way too front heavy, at least for me. The only thing holding it in place is a screw that is going to sit through here. Just let me unscrew this piece again. I'm not going to use it anyway. putting the muzzle nuts back in place. You can see the white plastic from the PVC pipe there, but yeah, whatever. So let's just attach the barrel and see how it looks like. Comes with a small nut, sits into the left side of the barrel there. So just wondering how deep this is going to sit. Maybe it will support the barrel on top there. Yeah, maybe I have to attach them after all. So maybe Florian Sølner at Home Defense 24 can make an extra barrel type of thing that can fit inside this one. At least if you remove the steel barrel. I think, when I'm going to try it now, that what might happen is this piece either might maybe boop, blow apart the inner barrel there, maybe we'll just shoot out the barrel. I don't know. It will be an interesting test. Yes. Let's charge it up. I have a restrictor inside. This is the 7.5 fuel version. Umarex CO2. The restrictor that sits inside is from tech23.de. Made by Stefan Weber. You can buy a power kit for this revolver from Home Defense 24 also, if you feel like it. So let's see. I have no idea how this will work, but let's try. If it don't work, it don't work. I'm using 77 grain slugs from homedefense24.com. So yeah, like so. Yes. Looks like something from a Dirty Harry movie or something. Huge. So, one moment. So, let's see how it goes. Gas it up. 77 grain slug. Let's see how the barrel and everything will hold up. This will be kind of interesting. 20 degrees Celsius, 66 degrees Fahrenheit, shot number one. .286. And the barrel started to slide forward. .328. Again, the barrel got even further out. So, not quite sure how to fix that. .298. Pieces of the barrel just shot into the trap there. Okay, now it is no inner barrel or barrel liner, just the 15 millimeter barrel. Let's see how it goes. .348. .340. .326. I have removed the barrel. It's the same CO2 canister, but it should still give at least a couple of more good power shots. Let's see if there is any difference. .270. .272. So yeah, actually it gives a little bit of rise in the velocity. It makes a heck of a crack. One more shot and then I will stop. .249. Maybe the CO2 canister is getting kind of low. .242. 226. Last one. $230. So this one works actually quite well with the barrel extension. So the barrel can be removed. Maybe you can use it with a longer barrel from Home Defense 24 if you remove the inner barrel here. It sure looks cool. And if you want to have the extremely heavy muzzle brake in the front, you can also put that on, removing the nut there. So, yes. Just some testing for you. Okay. Hope you liked the video. Thank you for watching.